DESMOND ELIOT. I represent Surulere, this place, at the Lagos State House of Assembly.
So, from the outcome of this election, what are your expectations of today?
Well, I expect it to be a bit slightly tense, not much, because we have two highly polarized situation. It's bigly divided. But you know, to God be the glory, everything will go on well. It's APC primaries, yes. To elect our candidate from amongst the aspirants. Well, I don't know about people omitted. Nobody was omitted from this ward. This is my ward, so I can't speak for the other ones or the reasons for which their names were omitted. But I can only talk about my ward and no names were omitted.
Sir, what are your advice to the electorate?
Well, they are all, as you see, calm down, seated. Everybody, able, disabled, happy, not too happy, everybody is here. You know? The only thing is, let's all observe. Everywhere I go, I'm telling them, put this on. You know, that's very important. We must still observe COVID protocols. It's very important.
Okay, sir, digressing a little bit, I want to ask you, how do you see the performance of the governor of Lagos State, Surulere?
Given all the challenges, given all the extreme challenges that we've had last year, from COVID we didn't expect, to whether for good or not for good, the state suffered a lot. There is no government that can operate without adequate funding. And we must know that. And for Lagos State to still be at par, you know, and still trying and striving, for the governor to have been able to make sure there is some great level of peace and harmony, you know, I don't think he's, there's no game saying that he's doing his best, you know, and I commend him. I commend not just him, I commend the judiciary as well, and I also commend the legislature, you know, which I also am a part of, because at the end of the day, these three bodies work together into making Lagos State get better. So,
okay, currently there's a lot of situations, or like say rough situations going on around the country, insecurities and all of that.
Plus, yeah. Insecurity is insecurity. I also feel insecure. The only thing is, we need to tackle the insecurity in the country. Do you understand? We need to tackle the insecurity in the country. We need to start looking deeply into certain things. So let's look into the insecurity situation, what the problems are, look for immediate, medium and long-term plans on curbing it. Bros, let's live and others live. You understand? Let people, why not? How many years do we all have to live in this life? That every day you can't sleep, you don't be close eye. You close eye and say, one go open. You know, so it's a serious situation, and I don't mind. I think we should even do a national referendum. Let people bring suggestions in this country, from the north, south, east and west. You know, it's peculiar to every community, but we have to look at it.
So what's your advice for the youth who may want to toe the line of destruction?
I've never been an advocate of destruction. I don't think destruction brings peace. You understand? Even two conflicting countries, they don't fight to resolve. They always go to the table to talk. Dialogue can make a queen get two husbands, if you can discuss it well. So my point is, there's no limit to which dialogue cannot go. Let's talk. Oh, we talk and understand that the country belongs to everybody.